गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम इन अवर मैथमेटिक्स क्लास। इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड फ्रैक्शंस, सो जस्ट रिकॉल बिफोर द न्यू टॉपिक इन द व्हाट इज एन फ्रैक्शन। व्हेनेवर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द फ्रैक्शन, फ्रैक्शन मींस अ पार्ट ऑफ होल, दैट इज कॉल्ड अ फ्रैक्शन। एंड इन द फ्रैक्शन व्हेनेवर वी आर टॉकिंग, इफ अ होल इज डिवाइडेड इन टू वेरियस पार्ट, वेरियस पीसेस, दैट इज काउंट टू बी अ लाइक if this apple is divided into two parts, so if I'm talking about this first piece of an apple, so it would be one and total piece we have two, so it will become two. So we have to write 1/2 for the first one and 1/2 for the second one. And whenever we are writing this way 1/2, as I said, when we are counting less than one, that term we are using to write the fraction. So 1 become the numerator and 2 become the denominator. Whenever we are talking about the numerator, what is the numerator? Numerator is the top digit that represent the part of the whole. Means the whole is 2 and a part of that whole, that is 1, that is numerator. And the same time, whenever we are talking about the denominator, denominator means the digit at the bottom that represent the whole. Means here we have the whole, means total 2 pieces of apple, so that will become the denominator. And together 1/2 we can read as fraction. How we are reading? 1/2. That we already learned. The next concept is like and unlike fraction. On the basis of this like and unlike fractions, we have to solve the next problem, set number 18. So let's see what is like fraction and what is unlike fraction. The first one is like fraction. Fractions whose denominators are equal are called like fractions. Whenever we have the two or more than two fractions, and at that time the denominator should be equal, so that fraction should be called like fraction. Suppose, for an example, if I said 5/3 and 6/3, these two fractions are like fractions. Yes? As because simply we should come to know the denominator in the both fraction is 3. So whenever we have the fractions and the denominator of the fraction should be same, so at that time we can say these two fractions are like fractions. Now come for the unlike fractions. What is unlike fractions? Fractions whose denominators are different are called unlike fractions. Example, if I said I had 5/3 and 9/7. So here we have the denominator 3 and here we have the denominator 7. Is it equal? No, these two denominators are different. So at that time we can say are unlike fraction. Yes? Whenever we want to identify the like fractions or unlike fractions, in that case we have to see that whether these two have the equal denominator or not. If the denominators are equal, they are like fraction. If the denominators are different, they call unlike fraction. Now the second type of question should be asked, we have to convert the unlike fraction into like fraction. So at that time how we are going to convert it? So let's see problem set 18, question number 1. Convert the following fractions into like fractions. If you are able to see these two fractions, in these fractions we have different denominator. As we learn, if we have the different denominator, means these fractions are unlike fractions. And we have to convert that into the like fractions. Means we have to make the denominator same, denominator equal. So at that time, how we should come to know? So first we have to find out the multiples of the denominators. Like if I am talking about this 4, what is the multiple of 4? That will become 4, 8, 12, 16, 20 and so on. And when we are talking about the multiple of 8, 8, 16, 24 and so on. So first we have to identify the common multiple. So you are able to see here we have the 8 and we have 16, but what we have to take, we have to take the least common multiple.
that is the first common multiple, that is 8. Means we have to convert these 4 and 8 into 8. So the second fraction, we have the denominator 8. There is no any issues. So first we are going to convert this 3 upon 4. To converting this 4 into 8, we have to multiply with the 2. And we learn if we are multiplying the denominator by any number, the same time we have to multiply the numerator also by the same number. So it will become 6 upon 8. And second we have the 5 upon 8 already. So now we got the same denominator. So can we say these two are the like fractions? Yes. Therefore 6 upon 8, 5 upon 8 are required like fractions. Yes. So this we have to mention our answers. The next one is 3 upon 5 and 3 upon 7. Again we have the different denominator. So as we learn, we have to find out the multiple of 5. What is the multiple of 5? 5, 10, 15, 20. Do you are getting what these are multiple? Means actually we are reading the table. 5 1 is 5, 5 2 is 10, 5 3 is 15, 5 4 is 20, 25, 30, 35, 40 and so on. If we are talking about the 7, again 7, 14, 21, 28, 35, 42 and so on. So what is the common multiple? Just check it. Here we have 35 and here we have 35. Before 35, do we have any common multiple? No. Means this will become our least common multiple. Means we have to convert this denominator into 35. And this thing, what we are doing over here, writing this multiple of the denominator, that you have to do in the rough. Just we got it, we have to convert the denominator into 35. So 3 upon 5. We want to convert this 5 into 35. As we learn, we need the more than that what we have. So 5 should be multiplied by which number we will get the 35? 5 sevens are. That is 5 sevens are 35. So numerator also multiply by the same number. 3 sevens are 21. This way. And second we have 3 upon 7. Again, what we have to multiply to the 7 to get 35, as we need the 35 in the denominator, so 5. So we are getting 7 5s are 35. If you are multiplying the denominator, we have to multiply the numerator also. 3 5s are 15. So here we got 21 upon 35 and 15 upon 35. So therefore we can say 21 upon 35 and 15 upon 35 are required like fraction. Yes. So this way we have to conclude our answers. Now come for the next one, the third sum, that is 4 upon 5 and 3 upon 10. Again we want to find out the common multiple, common least multiple of the denominator. That is the way we learn how we are going to check it. But the second method is that, just you see if the smaller denominator get the multiple the bigger denominator. Just check it. Do we are getting the 10 into 5's table? Yes, 5 2's are 10. So easily if we multiply 2 into this 5, we get the 10. And here we have already 10. So that could be equal denominator. So 4 upon 5, 5 should be multiplied by 2. So numerator also multiply by 2. It will become 4 2 is 8, 5 2 is 10. And this we have 3 upon 10 already. Therefore 8 upon 10 and 3 upon 10 are required like fractions. Yes. This way we have to convert the unlike fraction into like fractions. Now come for the next one. Here we have the fourth one. 2 upon 9, 1 upon 6.
Again, check it. What we learn? Do we are getting the 9 in the table of 6? No. Means now we have to find out the multiple. 9, 9, 18, 27 and so on. 6, 6, 12, 18, 24 and so on. Now if you are able to see, we are getting the least common multiple, that is 18. Means we have to convert this 9 and 6 into 18. Let's do it. So 2 upon 9, we want to convert this 9 into 18, means we have to multiply by 2. The same time numerator also multiply by 2. We are getting 2 2's are 4, 9 2's are 18. Come for the second fraction. 1 upon 6, this time we have to convert this 6 into 18. So 6 3's are 18. So numerator also multiply by the 3. We have to get the answer 3, 1's are 3, 6 3's are 18. Now we got 4 upon 18, 3 upon 18. Therefore, 4 upon 18 and 3 upon 18 are required like fractions. This way we have to conclude our answers. Come for the fifth one. Here we have the 1 upon 4 and 2 upon 3. So again 1 upon 4, we want to multiply with 4. This 4 should be multiplied by this 3, or the 3 multiplied by 4, then also we will get the like fraction. But as we learn, what is the multiple of 4? 4, 8, 12, 16 and so on. Multiple of 3, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15 and so on. If you can see, here we are getting the least multiple, that is 12. Means we have to convert this 4 and 3 into 12. So 1 upon 4, 4 3's are 12. So numerator also multiply by the 3. We'll get 3 upon 12. The second we have 2 upon 3. This time 3 4's are 12. So if the denominator is multiplying by 4, numerator also multiply by 4. We will get 4 2's are 8, 3 4's are 12. So therefore 3 upon 12 and 8 upon 12 are required like fraction. Yes? We have to always conclude our answers. One more we have, 5 upon 6 and 4 upon 5. Multiple of 6, 6, 12, 18, 24, 30, 36 and so on. Now you are getting a question, till how much we have to write the multiple. Just write it 3, 4, 5 times, and if then also we are not getting, just increase it. 5, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35 and so on. Approximately we come to know till where we are getting the common multiple. Here we are getting the common multiple 30, the least common multiple. So we have to convert this 5 and 6 into 30. So let's do it. 5 upon 6, 6 5 is 30. So 6 should be multiplied by 5. The same time numerator also multiply by 5. We are getting 25 upon 30. The second fraction we have 4 upon 5. Now 5, 6 is 30. So we have to multiply by 6. The numerator also multiply by 6. We are getting 4, 6 is 24 and 5, 6 is 30. So therefore we have to conclude our answer. 25 upon 30 and 24 upon 30 are required like fractions. Yes? So this way we learn how you are going to convert the unlike fraction into like fractions. We learn already like fractions means the fractions, those who have the equal denominator. And we learn how you are going to equalize the denominator. The same two sums you have the homework for you all.
3 upon 8 and 1 upon 6, and the 8th one 1 upon 6 and 4 upon 9. These two you have to do by yourself in your homework. Now you have to do the same by using same method what we did in the video. Just write the multiple of the denominator. You should be doing rough work, or you have to write it by pencil and scrub it, or if you are written, then also it will be okay. Now the big question arises that why we have to convert this unlike fraction to like fractions? As because in the next videos we are going to learn about the mathematical operations of the fractions. In that we have to use this like fractions, conversion of unlike fraction into the like fraction. As because whenever we are going to addition or the subtraction of any other two or more than two fractions, in that case we have to do only when it could be the like fractions. If they are not like fractions, means they are unlike fractions, we are not able to add or subtract the fractions. So because of that, these are the most important things to learn for ourselves. So keeping that all things in your mind, you have to complete your homework and submit it in your group. If you still have any kinds of a doubt, you should be asking your group. I have to solve the doubts. The next concept we will continue in the next video. Thank you so much.